Well, good morning. Welcome to worship here at St. Andrew. We're going to continue with our upbeat series of the gathering song. And so I encourage you, if you are willing and able, to rise up and help us sing, "My Life Is in You."
Rush towards December 25th and having those opportunities to slow down as a gift. If you are only able to come for one part or the other, if you're only able to come for supper, maybe you're a family with bedtimes, but you'd like to have fellowship and dinner taken care of, come join us for supper, and then it's okay to leave and not stay for evening prayer. Or maybe you're only able to get here for evening prayer. However you're able to show up, we welcome that. There is always plenty of food. I promise you, if you're not able to bring anything, there is always plenty, there is always leftovers, we always have enough. So truly show up as you are and as you are able. We would love to have you. Supper is at 6, service is at 7, we'll be done by about 7:30. So hope to see you here. The Christmas Eve schedule is in the blast, and on the website we have worship at 5 and 7:30. Both services will have all your favorite Christmas carols. They'll have the candlelight portion of the evening, and we will have communion. So whichever service works best for you and your family, you will be able to enjoy it to the fullest. And then last but not least, many of you were commenting on the absolutely beautiful, you know, if you guys, I'm so sorry, you guys can sit down. I'm sorry. Hi, welcome back. It's good to be back. I forgot, I've only been gone for like 2.5 months and I forgot how to do this. But as many of you have noted, Christmas tree is up and there's a beautiful backdrop, and that backdrop is intentional because Evan, our wonderful POP drummer, has very kindly offered to have that set up and to take pictures for anybody who would like to take family photos, individual photos, church family photos. You all love and care for each other here too. So if you want to wear your Christmas outfit as many times as possible, or let's say you couldn't choose between one and you have multiples, so now you got another reason to wear one of them. We would love to do that. It'll be offered in between and after services for the next few weeks. And is it Christmas Eve as well, or no? Probably not. Okay, awesome. I didn't want to say it was until you confirmed. So it's good. So not for Christmas Eve. So put on your special outfits or just come as you are again. It's always a special outfit, however you want it to be, and enjoy those photos. So thank you so much, Evan, for that. I think that's everything. Yeah, okay, wonderful. Well, with that, dear friends, let's turn our hearts and minds to our call to worship.
I invite you to rise up.
Only a minute of rest.
God says,
do not be afraid.
God says,
I have called you by name.
God says,
I will be with you.
God says,
you are precious and honored in my sight.
At the beginning of this season, at the start of this week, at the top of this hour,
may we wrap ourselves in these words. May we be in them. Let us worship our holy God.
Grace abounds as we bear with one another. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever.
Amen.
Mary's response to Gabriel's message is simple but awestruck. How can this be? This is how I approach confession each week. How can this be? How can God's grace and mercy and forgiveness be given to me each and every time? God's answer never changes, no matter what we might do. So let us join together in praying our confession, and may God's mercy leave you awestruck. We'll take a moment of silence before we continue. Affirming God, your first
words to creation were words of love. You looked at this earth and said, it is good. You spoke affirmations to the prophets. You spoke blessings over Mary. You spoke belonging to Christ. At every turn, you have reiterated that we are a blessing, being your image, held in your love. Forgive us for creating this truth. Forgive us for measuring our worth by society's measuring stick instead of yours. We believe, help our unbelief. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Family of faith, I don't know the last time that someone told you that you are good just as you are. I don't know the last time that you heard that you are loved and created in the image of God. I don't know the last time you trusted those words and truly believed that you are a blessing. However, in case it has been a while, hear these words from Isaiah, for God says,
do not fear. For I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine.
We are forgiven. We are loved. Let it leave you awestruck.
Thanks be to God. May we believe it. Amen.
Of water, earth, and sky.
Children's message. Sunday school, is there Sunday school today? Yes, there is. Yes. Anyone else wondering? Good morning. What is it? Candle? What is it? Are you looking at the screen or? Screen. This children's message is made, I can't read that. All right, let's get back focusing here. How are you all doing? Good? Good. My question of the day for you. Okay, you ready? I'll give you a moment to think about it. Have you ever been given some kind of a great responsibility from someone that you know? I'll give you a moment to think about it. Great responsibility. Got one response here. What was it? What was the responsibility that you had? Yes, to get all the ingredients for making pancakes. Very big responsibility in our house. Yeah, you come up with something? Oh, get the cheese on the pizza. All right, we got a lot of bacon. One. Yes, bringing your dirty, stinky clothes down, right, for the laundry machine, helping out that way. Yeah, taking care of her bunny, Rosebud. I love that name, by the way. Yeah, taking care of another animal, or maybe has anyone had to take care of maybe a younger brother or sister or cousin, just for maybe like a brief moment, and, you know, someone said, watch him or her, right? Make sure they don't crawl away or play with them, make sure they stay focused. Yeah? Okay, you got one? All right. And you have to feed Allie? Yeah. There's so many things that we are responsible for. And a lot of times, too, it's not something where we raised our hand and said, hey, can we do this, right? Someone came up to us and said, hey, I really need your help. I need to put this on you. I need you to be responsible and help me out, right? And I'm assuming that all these things that you just mentioned, you actually did it, right? It wasn't like someone asked you and you said, you thought about it, and you said, no, pass. You did these things, right? And you will continue to do many, many more of those things just like that. And I thought of one for myself, and it's you guys. The responsibility here that was given to me by the angel Jenna, she said, I would like you to do some children's messages. And I said, I feel the Holy Spirit within me. I'm going to say yes. And I'm so thankful to be here with you guys, in case I've never mentioned it before. Guess who else got a great big responsibility? I'll give you a hint. There was an angel, Gabriel. And we said her name already. I already gave you another hint. We said her name already. He came to her and said, I have a whopper for you. What did he, yes, Mary. And what did he say? What did he tell her? You're going to have a baby, right? And not only are you going to have any baby, but you're going to have who? God's baby. That's right. And she's probably like, oh, wow, right? The first thing that she said, we already said it a couple times again, said, how can it be? This is impossible. How can it be? So they went back and forth, they explained it and all that. And at the end, you know what she said? I'm going to read it off here at the time. It's in our gospel today. I thought it's pretty neat. I know, right? Who wants to read it for me? All right, you see the underlined words there?
Here you go.
Did Mary say yes? She did, right? Fortunately, she didn't say, like, no, hard pass. Right? Move on. She said yes. She said, I am your servant. I will do as you see fit. So let's all be responsible for doing what? Being good, Be good. C word. Taking responsibility, but be good Christians. There you go. We finally got it. Citizens. Oh, citizens. Oh, well, that's good too. Christian citizens. All right, are we ready to pray? Here we go.
Dear Jesus.
You give us all responsibility.
You give us all responsibility.
To Mary.
Bringing you into the world.
To the wise men.
Providing gifts and keeping you safe.
To the animals.
Creating warmth in the stable.
Yeah, a little side note, I read it and the animal breathes. I read that.
To us.
Sharing your love.
And hope.
To everyone we meet.
Amen.
All right, great job.
Called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in exchange for you. Because you are precious in my sight and honored, and I love you, I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east, and from the west I will gather you. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away, and my daughters from the end of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you to rise and prepare to give word of the gospel.
There is none like you.
Chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin whose name was Mary, who was engaged to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and wondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth in her old age has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
I invite you to please be seated. Beloveds of God, grace and peace to you in the name of the one for whom we wait. Amen. With this start of the new church year, right? First Sunday of Advent is the start of a new church year. We start a new season, church season, again, we're looking at church perspective here. Start a new church season, we are starting a new month today, December 1st, what happens to November? And we are entering this time of year that gives us an opportunity to reflect more deeply on God's good news. And this year, we are using the framework of the theme, Words for the Beginning, to help us do that. This season is filled with blessings. It is filled with words that we need to hear again and again, and it's why we do it each and every year. This year, we're invited to imagine the words that Mary would have chosen to impart to her newborn son. What prayers, blessings, and scriptures would she have shared with him? What are the prayers, blessings, and scriptures that we draw from as we grow into and spend our lives in adulthood? These are the words from the beginning. Right, the church year, as I kind of mentioned during my welcome and announcements, the church year pushes back against the rush of the world, the rush that is trying to, like, get us to December 25th as fast as possible. Now, don't get me wrong, I love Christmas. If I didn't have children, my tree would have been up like a month ago. I love it. But Advent is a gift. It is a time to slow down, take a breath, and pause. Because for many of us, December just means more, more, more. It means more school events, right? How many school parties and rehearsals and church plays and all the extra stuff, right? More parties and gatherings, all your family and friends and the annual white elephant you do with your mom's book club that has barely actually read the book, any of the books this year. Right? All more shopping, more cooking, more traveling, more, more, more. And in Advent, God says, wait as you get ready for the inbreaking of God made flesh with the birth of Jesus Christ. As we wait the remembrance of his first arrival, and as we long for his permanent return. So then, what words are we holding fast to as we enter this new sacred chapter of the year? Maybe even of our lives. The gospel for today takes us back to the beginning with Mary, who receives an unexpected and frankly confusing guest. Because Mary was like the last person to expect a visit from an angel, right? Like, she was a teenager. She was female, and she was from Galilee, of all places. Right? She wasn't a priest or a scholar or anyone special at all. Scholar Kali Nakandaha explains that the northern region of Israel was considered lesser by the rest of Israel. Many of the Galilean Jews were uncircumcised, they didn't worship at the temple in Jerusalem, and they had married non-Jewish people. It was this trifecta of bad behavior. And to add insult to injury, they were also known for their uprisings and protests. Nazareth had nothing to offer. And that is where God chose to go, to find the one who would bear his word into the world. Because God isn't looking at what is valuable by the standards of the world. God looks and sees differently, because in God's economy, there is room for the people and the places that the world just doesn't value. And we see this play out in the way in which Gabriel greets Mary. He meets her with kindness and reassurance. Right? Think about that. She is no one and nothing, and an angel of the Lord says, "You are a favored one. Do not be afraid, for you have found favor with God." Her story begins with blessedness, for she is a blessing. It's where our story starts too. It starts at a place of blessedness because we are a blessing. The prophet Isaiah tells us we are a blessing because we belong to God. When blessedness is our beginning, we can see the world and others through the eyes of a God who says, "You are precious in my sight." It is a radical message of love and hope that is counter to everything that the world tells us and reinforces, which is that we're nothing at best, and at worst, that we're a burden. The world teaches us that we have to hustle to earn our worth, that we have to be involved in everything, say yes to everything, be more, 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 that there aren't enough resources for everyone to have enough, that, again, we aren't a blessing, but we're a burden. That is the teaching, the lessons of the world. And so God's word at the start of the incarnation shows us that what most people see as scraps, as something to just throw away and ignore and discard, right, out of sight, out of mind, God looks and he sees and he calls them good, calls them beautiful and blessed. Mary wasn't someone with power or prestige, but she was wrapped in God's wonderful belovedness. Kind of sounds too good to be true, doesn't it? No matter how many times we have heard this story, I imagine that there are many of us who look at that and go, "Yeah, but that was different. That was a different situation, different person. Just, that's too good to be true. That can't be me." Even Mary asks, "How? How is this going to happen? How can this be? What do you mean I'm going to have a baby? I'm not married yet." Right? Because that's how it was supposed to go back then. But what does it always come to with God? It always comes back to love. God's deep love for humanity drives the incarnation and God's care for how it all comes about. And it is this love that serves as its own force in history, as God's love takes shape through generations of ordinary, unexpected, and often vulnerable people. Because while these words may be for the beginning, the incarnation isn't the start of God's love and hope in the world. It is the culmination of God's love and hope. When we read the Annunciation with this point of view, God invites us to reflect on what that love and hope really, what they really are for us, how they really play out in our lives. The Christmas story and Mary's role in it is a story of love and hope that spans so many generations. It is a story of love and hope coming to be with us through prestigious prophets and nowhere towns, through venerable priests and vulnerable young women, through stars and shepherds and scripture and song. It just takes my breath away that this was how God chose to reconcile humanity to God's self. In a world that is often thoroughly steeped in pain and suffering, grappling with injustice, God reminds us that we have been formed and made by the one who loves us, stays with us, and tells us that we are a blessing. You are a blessing. You are a blessing. You are a blessing. How can it be, we ask with hopefulness and awe, where the world has taught us that we have to earn our worth, prove ourselves. God teaches us that our blessedness and belovedness are given because we are God's. Here we are, Lord. Let it be with us according to your word. A blessing. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Well, I looked through the bulletin. Moment ago. And I saw the word blessings at least 19 times. That probably wasn't enough, but I think we have all heard that we are blessed. And that is worthy of our rejoice. Please rise.
Thank you.
Today, we affirm our faith together through this prayer of affirmation.
We believe in a blessing God who calls us beloved. We believe that this blessing showed up in the life of Mary and was also bestowed upon the hemorrhaging woman. The poor in spirit, the children, the crowds, the Jews, the Gentiles, the faithful, and the doubting. So in faith we trust that God's blessings, like ripples on the water, forever reaches towards us. And with wild hope, we believe that because of this blessing, we are covered in love. We are more than enough. Thanks be to God. Amen.
I invite you to be seated. As we prepare for Emmanuel, God with us, let us pray for all peoples and places that long for God's presence. Meet us here, gracious God. God of hope, thank you for the people who, like the angel Gabriel, help us see you in our midst. Thank you for faith mentors, for friends that greet us with hugs, smiles at church, for the saints who have gone before us, for Sunday school teachers and youth advisors. Thank you for these saints and the ways they always point us toward you. Pour out your blessings on them. Thank you for the people who, like Mary, have shown us what it looks like to trust our belovedness. Thank you for the folks in our lives who have acted with fierce bravery, trusting their call and your words and blessing. Their faith and conviction inspires our own. God of hope, hear our prayer. In addition to prayers of gratitude, we also offer prayers for guidance. For even though we count this day as a new beginning, the words and messages of the past cling to us like quicksand. Today we lift up those of us who have been ever told that we are unworthy or are not enough by this demanding society. We pray for those of us who have ever been discouraged from chasing a dream or have been made to feel small. We pray for those of us who know insecurity and dance with self-doubt. We pray for all who hear your words of blessing and want to respond, "How can it be?" Let this day be a new beginning, Creator God. Erase our memories of self-doubt. Erase the "how can this be" questions from our minds. Erase our insecurities and fears, and in their place, fill our hearts with trust. Fill our spirits with conviction. Fill our minds with the knowledge that, like Mary, we are made in your image. Like Mary, we are good. God of hope,
hear our prayer.
We pray this morning for James Yu, for health and recovery from an onset stroke. We pray for Shelley and Mia, the Bosco family, new mother and baby. We pray for Abby, that she may have the strength that she needs to recover from neck surgery. We pray for the elderly and their blessed caregivers that are so patient and have so much love to offer. God of hope,
hear our prayer.
God of blessings, once again, we find ourselves standing at the beginning of the month, at the beginning of this Advent season, at the beginning of this new day, bringing our hearts to you. So on this new day, we pray. Speak your words of blessing once again. In the name of Christ, amen.
May the peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
I invite you to share a sign of that peace with one another. Thank you.
seat. As we receive this morning's offering, we offer this prayer. God of hope,
you have blessed us to be a blessing. You share the abundance back to you.
Take these gifts and use them. Use us to share your hope and your blessings with your world. Amen.
Please rise as you are able, in body and in spirit. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Loving God, we come to this table today longing for a new beginning. In a world that so often feels like it's ending, we crave the hope of a new beginning. We long to heal from the endings and crash landings of our hurting world and start again, rooted in your good news. So week by week, bit by bit, we return to your word. Week by week, bit by bit, we return to each other. Week by week and bit by bit, we repeat the truths that we so often need to hear, trusting that by your grace, it is never too late to start again. So in the spirit of beginnings, we come to your table, where we remember that the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took the bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "Take and drink. This cup is the new covenant shed in my blood for you and all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Pour out your spirit on this ordinary meal, that in this bread and cup we may glimpse a new day. May the sight of everyone being welcomed at this table remind us that we all are loved by you. May the evidence that there is food for all remind us that no one is meant to go hungry. May the fact that our own shame, sin, and doubt do not keep us from this table remind us that you welcome and love us as we are. With joy and hope, we weave our voices together to pray the words your Son taught us to pray. I invite you to hold the hands of your neighbors as you feel comfortable and led to do so. We pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
The table is set, all is ready, all are ready. May be seated. Again, we think the world is too far gone. We think we've made too many mistakes. But then we come to this table and we get a glimpse of your kingdom. We come to this table and all are welcomed, all are seen, all are fed. And just like that, we have hope and we begin again. Thank you for the gift of this fresh start. Thank you for planting hope deep in our bones. Thank you for meeting us in ordinary bread and juice and wine to remind us that it is never too late to build your kingdom here. We are grateful. We are so grateful. Dear ones, as we go now from this place, we go blessed by God to be a blessing. He sends us now with these words. As you leave this place, may you have the wisdom to lean on one another. May you have the courage to hold onto hope, the compassion to do the good that is yours to do, and the confidence to trust that God sees you as a blessing. For in a world full of dead ends, Advent invites us to begin again. So start here, start now, start with love and begin again. And may the God of endings and beginnings, God in the darkness and the light, God our hope for the journey, bless and keep you now and forever. Amen. Amen.
I stand here thinking of what I can say, help inspire, help encourage, and I keep coming back to that question today. How can it be? It can be. And that is a hallelujah. God has called us to.
St. Andrew is a church where all are welcome, fed, and nourished in the name of Jesus Christ.
So go in peace. Christ is near.
Thanks be to God.